Welcome to .NET, my conference focused on MAUI. My name is Kinfey Lo. I'm Microsoft Cloud Advocate. I'm in China. If you want to know me, you can access my GitHub. If you have any question, you can leave your answer in my GitHub. It's okay. Today, I will introduce how to binding native library in .NET MAUI. I think you know .NET MAUI technology, but binding a native library is very important. Let's go. .NET MAUI, today, I think many speakers introduce .NET MAUI in different technology. You know, .NET MAUI can run any platforms, any device. Many people say, oh, .NET is cool. .NET developers love the .NET MAUI. But many people say, how to create the best apps in .NET MAUI? Many people love to install applications in different devices. Just like that, you always love social media apps. Another is you can install some news apps. But why you choose these apps, why your customer love the applications is very important. I think a good application needs four things. The first thing is UI and UX. Why? Because if you use applications, you see the UI is cool. You love this. Many people love the beautiful UI and beautiful UX. Another is you love applications. If you always use these applications, you want that this application not only one device. Just like that, you always use the applications in your mobile. When you come back, I think you always use the pad to use these applications. Another is when you are in the business, I think if you have time, you want to use these apps in your laptop. Also, I think cross any device is very important too. Another is you want the apps include or many functions just like that. If you create the photograph apps, when you take a photo, you want to share the photo in social media, just like some Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok. Another is if you drive car applications, you always use the map controls. Another is you write some business apps, you want to connect the office applications. So this is the third-party SDK, but the developer not create the Facebook again. He needs to connect the SDK in different scenario. So UI and UX is for designer jobs. Any device is the technology jobs, just like .NET MAUI can support the any device solution. But in the third-party SDK, I think many people say, I'm .NET developer, but I don't know how to binding the iOS SDK and Android SDK, because this is not the same language and not the same library in C#. Yeah. So how to building native SDK in .NET MAUI is a problem, because many people say .NET MAUI can create the cross-platform solution and create the beautiful UI. So now, binding native SDK, is okay? I say, it's okay. Just like that, SDK, if you know that, SDK in different platforms has different format. In .NET, the .dll format files is for Windows. Another is iOS, and Matt solution is always that this is .a and .framework for a file format. Other is Android. Android has some .jar and .ar formats. And Linux is the .so files. Many people say they, if you want to call different platform, different say SDK, you need to use different language. You need those always use C#. iOS is use Objective-C or Swift. Android is always use Java and Kotlin. Linux is always use C++ and anything. So, if .NET MAUI is cross-platform solution, how to net C# to binding and different language for different platform? I think the first thing I will introduce iOS library. You know that in iOS library has dynamic libraries and static libraries. Static library, you need to binding the third-party SDK in the in your app. So, the app size is very big. Dynamic libraries, you not all including applications in your applications. So the application size is very small than static library. But when you change the libraries or the dynamic library is will maybe not good for some scenario. So dynamic libraries and static libraries is very more useful in iOS applications. But how to use this iOS library in .NET MAUI? I think ShopPy is cool. ShopPy tools is from Xamarin and forms. If you are Xamarin developer, you maybe hear this cool technology. You know that if we, you install the ShopPy in Mac OS, you can convert Objective-C to C# formats. Just like that, if you want to install the ShopPy in Mac OS, you can access this link. Another is if you finish the Objective-C Objective ShopPy, you know that a command line, ShopPy, by a slash framework and give the your framework path and then SDK. You know that the third party SDK in iOS always support the latest SDK, but maybe some SDK not support the latest SDK. You need to use Xcode to download the SDK. It's very easy. Just like that, I AMAP native library support the latest SDK in iOS. So I use this command line to finish the convert Objective-C to C#. If your generation two C# files like the graph, you can see that the framework always include that. Another is if you want to create the native binding projects for iOS, now Visual Studio Learn support this. I think and with Visual Studio will support this soon, but now you only create the binding projects in command line. So you need to .NET workflow to install MAUI and create the .NET new iOS binding and to create the native binding projects. You can see if you've use the command line to create the .NET iOS binding library, native library projects. You can see the project files it is target framework is .NET 6/iOS, and then you use the command line to generation two C sub files API and struts and enumers. Object C binding API and object C binding and call source is in the item group. Another is native reference. Native reference is including your framework path. It supports the framework and stated library. Another is first low and sparkling. You need to read the framework document to know when you use the sparkling or a true or false is important. So if we want to binding the native library in iOS, you need to read the framework document tool. Oh, of course, you finish. When you compile the first, you will not create a successful it, because maybe the SharpPy help you to object C to convert to C sharp, but maybe many errors just like that. Some is late space errors and mass errors and return errors and type errors. If you want to know more about this, I write some documents for this. You can read this link and to finish that. I think I can help you to summary the object C and C sub how to serve the errors. But I suggest you to know some object C knowledge because the tools lock or convert all the languages. So if you want to finish a native binding in iOS, you need to know more iOS knowledge, including Object-C and Swift. I think it can help you to improve .NET MAUI bindings. The second is Android. But before Android topic, I've said this is the .NET for iOS solution to call the native library. I think you think this is very, very, very cool because C sharp can call the native library in iOS. And then I will introduce Android library. Many people say Java and C sharp is the same language. If you know this, you think maybe Java or Android library convert to C sharp is more easier than iOS because in the .NET MAUI or Xamarin, use the MCW rules to help you to convert Java codes to C sharp. I think MCW is a JNI bridge that is used when manage code leads to call Java code. If you want to know this, you can search MCW and Xamarin.Android. It tells you the more of things. If we want to grade the Android native bindings, you can see the command line in the topic. Of course, we want the Visual Studio support this template soon. If you agree the native binding in Android, you can see the project files. It is different on .NET iOS projects because native library in Android has support different hardware. In this case, I will support ARM system. ARM hardware system and x86 and 64 hardware. Another is it will help us to generate free XML files Another is including and the jar, the .NET, the native library path including. So I think if you want to create the Android native library, you need to focus this setting. The architecture, I think many people say metadata XML, enumel fields .xml, enumel mass.xml is very important free XML files for Android Java convert to CSR. Because different SAM XML has different functions. Metadata has very, very important things because it changes some bindings just like that. You need to rename some namespace, class, method, and follow the .NET convert. Another is delete the unneeded namespace, class, and method and fields. Another is additional some class to make the design for the .NET patterns. So if you do this, if you build the Android native library projects, you need to focus the .NET for iOS native library binding. So I summary the Android binding skill in this link. If you want to know more, you can check this link. And now you can create the .NET for Android projects to call the native binding and to use the AMAC solutions. I think many people say, Kinfey, you finished the .NET for iOS or for Android solution, but .NET MAUI, how to create it for .NET MAUI? Well, because many people say .NET MAUI can use the same code, use the same things to finish the project. So I will talk about some controls for the .NET MAUI because native binding and finish, many native binding is controller. Some native binding is some social media. So if you finish this, you want to create the .NET MAUI controls. You know that if you want to customize the view handler, it support help you to finish the custom controls. Just like that, in here, I create the AMAC MAUI controls. I always create the interface, IAMAC interface, and create the view handler for iOS SDK and Android SDK. This is the some coding in the .NET MAUI controller for the AMAC native binding. After native binding, you can check this markdown. I think it can help you to know more how I can do this. If you want to get the full project, you can access the this GitHub link. I write the English tutorial and Chinese tutorial to talk about this. If you have some question, you can give me some issues to talk about this. Okay, my session is finished. Thank you for joining my sessions. Hope to see you soon because I have many .NET MAUI samples and bot in the future. If you have some ideas or if you have some question, you can answer in my GitHub. See you again. Bye bye.